maxillary artery. Maxillary artery, it is the largest terminal branch of the external carotid artery. This is the external carotid artery. It divides into the intratemporal fossa by the two terminal branches. One is the superficial temporal and another is the maxillary artery. This one is the maxillary artery. Maxillary artery, it divides into the three parts by the lateral pterygoid muscles. Here there is a, this is a forceps. We have already removed the lateral pterygoids, but the lateral pterygoids, it divides the artery into the three parts. You just image, this one is the forceps, is the lateral pterygoids. So artery proximal to the lateral pterygoid, it is the first part. Behind or anterior, either posterior or either anterior to the lateral pterygoids, this is the second part. And third part, it is the distal part of the maxillary artery. The first part of the maxillary artery, it gives the five branches. This one is the deep auricular. The second branch, it is the anterior tympani. This one is the anterior tympani. First one is the deep auricular, anterior tympani. Third one is the middle meningeal artery. Here you can see this one is the artery which is just a second. This one is the middle meningeal artery, larger one, and just around it, this one is the accessory meningeal artery. So this one is the accessory meningeal artery, and this one is the middle meningeal artery, and fifth one is the inferior alveolar artery. So first part of the maxillary artery gives the five branches: deep auricular, then anterior tympanic, inferior alveolar artery, and it gives the two larger branches. It is the first one is the middle meningeal artery, and smaller one, it is called the accessory meningeal artery. So this one is the middle meningeal artery, and this one is the accessory meningeal artery. Second part gives the branches. This one is the buccal branches, pterygoid branches. This one is the deep temporal, and fourth one is the mesenteric branches. This is the mesenteric. Third part of the maxillary artery gives the posterior superior alveolar artery on the posterior surface of the maxilla, and the remaining branches which enter inside the pterygopalatine fossa, and it gives the branches are the pharyngeal, greater palatine, and artery to the pterygoid canal, and spinopalatine artery. So these are the branches of the maxillary artery. Once again, the branches of the maxillary artery, one is the deep auricles, deep auricular artery. Second is the anterior tympani. Third is the inferior alveolar artery. And here there are two artery: middle meningeal artery, and this one is the accessory meningeal artery. And the muscular branches into the second part, this is the deep temporal, this one is the buccal branches, pterygoid branches, and mesenteric branches. And third part gives the posterior superior alveolar. It gives the pharyngeal branches, artery to the pterygoid canal, and spinopalatine and greater palatines, and continues on as an infraorbital artery. These are the branches of the maxillary artery.